Hello students, we are doing chapter 2 of our book Indian Economic Development. In our last lecture, we did economy, economic system, its types and plans. Today we will discuss how the different 5-year plans covering the period from 1950 to 1990 attempted to attain 4 goals. You should remember, in our last lecture, we did 4 basic goals. These were goals of growth, goal of modernization, goal of self-reliance and goal of equity. Today we will discuss, did these 5-year plans succeed in achieving these 4 objectives? And if yes, then to what extent? And this discussion, we will analyze with agriculture, industry and trade sector. So, let us start with our primary and most important sector, agriculture sector. Agriculture is the main occupation of our Indian economy. Because nearly 75% of the population was engaged in it at the time of independence. Not only that time, today also, it provides employment to around 50% population of the country. Agriculture is regarded as a basic industry, as agriculture is the backbone of our Indian economy. Backbone is that bone on which the entire human body stands. Likewise, agriculture is that sector on which our whole Indian economy stands. Agriculture is the ultimate source of all agricultural and non-agricultural goods. It produces both food for the entire humanity and raw material for consumer goods industries. Agriculture plays a major role in the overall development of the country. Now you are thinking, what is agriculture? Agriculture refers to all those processes, all those activities which are related to production of food crops, rice, wheat, jowar, and also non-food crops like cotton, jute, etc. It produces goods through exploitation of natural resources. First of all, we should focus on the point that what is the importance or role of agriculture sector in our present Indian economy, or why we regard agriculture as the backbone of our Indian economy. The answer to this question is, it provides employment to nearly 50% of working population of India. Not only this, but a large number of people earn living by working in occupation dependent on agriculture, like storage, procuring, trade, marketing and export of agricultural products. It means that agriculture is the principal source of generating employment. Not only this, agriculture is also important because its contribution was 55% in GDP. Which has come down to 12.3% at constant prices. But still nearly 25% of India's GDP depends on the primary sector, to which agriculture is the largest contributor. We should make it clear that primary sector includes many activities like fishery, poultry, farming, but agriculture is one of them. Agriculture is also important because it has a big role in the development of industries, especially the agro-based industries, such as the industry of textiles, sugar, tea, paper, handloom, weaving and other cottage industry depends on input on agriculture. The prosperity of these agro-based industries is directly dependent upon the availability of input from the agricultural sector. If input in the form of agricultural produce is not provided to these agro-based industries, they can't grow, they can't produce. Agriculture sector is also important because it provides food to people. People spend a large proportion of their income on food and food products. If food is costly, the cost of living of the people also gets affected to a great deal. Agriculture does not provide only food to the humanity, but it also provides fodder to sustain livestock like cattle, buffaloes, sheep, poultry, etc. Another important feature of agriculture is its low capital output ratio. Means it requires lesser capital per unit of output produced compared with industries. It is agriculture which solved the problem of urban congestion. Agriculture plays an important role in export also. At the time of independence and a number of years thereafter, our main export agricultural products were cotton, textiles, jute, and tea. Only these three goods accounted for more than 50% of our export earnings. This is great. As economy developed, the share of agricultural export in total export fell down to 10% due to various reasons which we will discuss later on. Agriculture sector generates domestic income and foreign exchange for the country. India imports agro product but only 3% of national import because we are self-sufficient in the production of agricultural produce. We import agro products only at the time of crisis, only when there are severe shortages resulting from unfriendly weather conditions like droughts and flood. Agriculture serves the basic support to grow transport industries as railways and roadways are the major carriers of farm produce of agriculture sector. Ultimately, on the basis of all the points, we can say that over a period of time, India has become self-sufficient in the production of agro products. But still, there are some problems which are faced by our agriculture sector. Problems of present Indian agriculture are, first, the main problem is low level of productivity. It is the main drawback of agricultural sector. Productivity is low due to backward or primitive state of technology. Old methods of plugging, sowing and harvesting and irrigation facilities are also of very primitive type. Productivity means produce per unit area. No doubt, India is one of the largest producers of most of the agricultural crops, but it ranks very low in terms of yield. You should know the difference between production and productivity. Production is the entire production which we have produced, and productivity means production per unit area. We are rich in production, but we are poor in productivity. Example. It is second largest producer of rice and wheat in world, but in terms of productivity, its world rank is 52 in rice and 38 in wheat. This is as low that it is not sufficient to meet the rising demands of fast growing population, which leads to inflationary pressure, as when demand exceeds supply, the price rises and inflation occurs. So, this was the main problem of agricultural sector, low level of productivity. Now, second problem of agricultural sector is that growth in agricultural sector has been often below the planned targets. There are regional imbalances in the growth. Like, growth is rich in certain areas like Punjab, Haryana and Western Uttar Pradesh. About 60% net sown area is rain fed in our country. As we know, our agriculture depends on monsoon for irrigation facilities. And when 60% net sown area is rain fed, there are no appropriate dry farming techniques and our most of the produce gets spoiled. Only 40% of the gross cropped area has irrigation facilities, which is very low. Indian agriculture depends on traditional inputs like cow dung, manures, etc. Modern inputs like pesticides, fertilizers, chemical fertilizers are not used in abundance, which slows down marketable surplus as required. One more major problem in agricultural field is problem of subdivision and fragmentation. Because of small and scattered land holdings resulting in wastage of time, money and efforts. Land tenure system in India is also defective, even after land reforms. Most of the landlords in India let out their holdings to others for farming. These landlords depend on rental income and share the revenue, but they do not share the cost of cultivators. Therefore, actual tillers of the soil, that is farmers, are not left with a surplus, and land continues to be used as a mere source of living for these poor farmers. Problem relating to approach is also major. Indian farmers does not like to act as an entrepreneur who works to make profits. Their approach is towards only subsistence oriented, only for self-consumption. Finance. It is also a big problem in Indian agriculture. At the time of independence, farmers get credit from money lenders as from zamindars, because banks and financial institutions were in the private hands, and these private hands were not interested in providing credit to these farmers, as farmers are the weaker section of the society. These money lenders charged very high rate of interest, and the interest rate was from 80% to 50%. To solve this problem of finance, 14 major banks were nationalized in July 1969. Again, 6 more banks were nationalized in 1980. But in 1993, among these 20 banks, 2 banks were merged. So at present, how many banks are nationalized? These are 19. Regional rural banks and further NABARD, National Bank for Agriculture and Rural Development, was also established. And the objective behind their establishment was providing credit to the rural and other priority sectors faster and at cheaper rates. Here I will like to tell you that the priority sectors are 3 for our economy, and these are agriculture, small industries and export. But even after all these efforts, still Indian farmers are not rich and they need more financial help. Even today, farmers are being exploited by the private money lenders, as number of banks providing credit is inadequate. Because population residing in villages is more than 70%, but banks in villages are only about 37%. So this data, 70% of population and 37% of banks, shows greater disparity. It shows that still banks are more needed in the villages to provide credit to the farmer. Problem relating to warehousing is also major. Storage facilities are of very primitive types in the form of dug holes and pits. As a result, 10 to 15% produce is eaten by rats, and no, 10 to 15% is not a small amount. It is a total national loss of agricultural produce. However, government agencies like Food Corporation of India provide storage facilities, but these are still insufficient. Next problem of agricultural sector is marketing. Farmers do not get fair price from the purchasers due to lack of marketing facilities. There are a number of agents between the producers, that is farmers, and consumers, that is buyers. And these agents charge a heavy amount as their commission. Another commonly known problem of Indian agriculture is disguised unemployment. The term disguised means hidden. It means more than required number of people are working on farm. It seems that all are working, but if some of them are withdrawn from farm, the total production would not reduce at all. It is a total waste of human energy. So, above discussed, all problems of agriculture sector are very crucial and they cannot be altogether ignored. There is a need to develop immediate marketing infrastructure, storage, warehousing, cold chains, spot markets, finance, modern technology, irrigation facilities, etc. to improve this fundamental sector of our economy. Now, let's throw some light on the causes of stagnation and backwardness of Indian agriculture. It is the time to know what are the reasons behind the backwardness of Indian agriculture. And the first cause is impact of partition. India's agriculture was highly adversely affected by partition at the time of independence, because a large amount of fertile land went to Pakistan and it caused food crisis. Another reason for backwardness of Indian agriculture is population. Increasing pressure of population, due to which per capita availability of land has been reduced from 0.444 hectares in 1921 to just 0.226 hectares in 1981. Within 60 years, per capita availability of land has become half. Third cause behind the backwardness is small size of holdings. Increasing pressure of population on agricultural land has created the problem of subdivision and fragmentation of holdings. Nearly 75% of the total holdings are less than 2 hectares in size, which is uneconomical for purpose of using modern expensive inputs like fertilizers. Fourth reason responsible for backward growth is dominance of subsistence farming. Nearly 2/3 of agricultural holdings are cultivated by farmers just for their self-consumption and not for sale in the market. And this type of cultivation is known as subsistence farming. Productivity of such holdings is very low due to involving small expenditure and using traditional inputs. Fifth reason is inadequate credit facilities. Credit is not available to the farmers at fair rate of interest. Sixth reason is inadequate agricultural price policy of the government. Government often guarantees minimum price to the farmers, known as support price or procurement price. But it is often argued by farmers that this price is not remunerative from them. Last but not least, seventh reason for backwardness of agricultural sector is defective land tenure and tenancy system. The owners of farm were jamindars, but tillers on it were farmers. The profit accruing out of the agricultural sector went to jamindar in the form of lagan or rent, regardless of the economic conditions of the farmers. Therefore, some reforms were taken into account in agricultural sector to improve it and to work more efficiently. So, students, this all was for today. Let's summarize our today's lecture. We started with the meaning of the agriculture, importance of agriculture, and why it is known as primary sector. As agriculture is our main sector, so it needs more elaboration, but we will do in our next lecture. So, thanks for today.